Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Oxymoron Gaming Presents the Council of the Morons, where we will be discussing the Steam sales and general bullshittery. Everybody open up Steam, except Pants, who's already playing a game.
Yeah, thanks. Well, yeah, I am.
The Lunar New Year sale, which they really should just say Chinese New Year sale, really. That's what they mean.
It's the Lunar New Year sale. I'm looking
It's just Chinese New Year.
I'm looking at the banner right now.
Yeah, I know, but it's just Chinese New Year. That's what they really mean.
Yes, yeah, that's what they really mean, yeah.
Wait, can you even get Steam in China thinking about it?
Lunar New Year sale kind of rolls off the tongue a bit more enjoyably.
That's only because you're thinking of Chinese children making Nike trainers.
I fail to see your issue. China is the land of the cheap, like, e-cig gear.
We do love cheap e-cig gear.
Oh, yes.
And Steam is the land of cheap-ish video games.
It is.
Well.
Land of very cheap video games, generally speaking.
Which we touched upon on GV Live the other day, that what's the point of pirating anymore with so many fine sales? When you can get everything nice and cheap anyway.
Because I'm poor as fuck.
Because nobody pays anybody to the developers and then get pissy when everything ends up getting on console first.
Fine.
Anyway, moving on from the piracy bullshit. Yes, Steam sale. Is there anything good?
Yeah, Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic 2 is on sale. £2.09 and a steal, if you can ever get it to work.
I think I own it, and I just never bothered to ever try to get it to work.
The Witcher franchise is on sale.
So we won't bother having that, then.
Binding of Isaac Rebirth is on sale, which, to be honest, if you haven't played it by now and you're a YouTuber, there's very little point in fucking playing it.
We haven't done it.
No,
nobody wants to.
I don't like those sorts of games. Like,
what kind of game is it anyway? I don't know anything.
It's a roguelike.
Ah.
But the thing is, yeah, pretty much every like developer is attaching the word roguelike to pretty much any fucking game.
Yeah, I'm not actually quite sure what roguelike means anymore. I used to know what it means. But now, not so much.
Is this a moment of, I used to be cool? I think I'm still cool. It must be the children who are wrong.
No, it's most definitely the children that are wrong, but I'm pretty sure I'm not cool.
Yeah, Spore. Yeah, you don't want to buy that abomination.
No, because you've got to constantly be connected to the internet, and the EA system sucks. Prison Architect, though, that's only $9.99.
Which is a good price. I think I paid that when it was in early access, so that's a good deal.
Yeah.
It is a good game. I haven't put the hours into it, I will admit.
No,
I've properly get to grips with it.
I've got it as well, and I really should start playing it. Because I'm pretty sure... Didn't they add multiplayer into it?
No. I don't think they did. Or I think they did. I think someone even plays as prisoners. No, it's still single player. There was talk about having, like, one person plays the prisoners trying to escape.
Yeah, well, that's in version 1. That's, You can play as prisoners. And
oh yeah, you can play as prisoners, but it's only single player. I think there was talk of making it like multiplayer.
But what you can do is you can download other people's prisons.
Oh yeah, there's some really good ones. There's an there's a concentration camp map for it. I saw it like months ago.
We would get stung on YouTube with that because I would constantly.
We'll never be able to show it in Germany. We'll start there.
Why? Oh, screw you, Warhammer.
Germans, the German, like, anti-Nazi laws, basically.
In Germany, World War II never happened.
Well, the Nazis, we don't talk about them in Germany.
No.
Oh my god.
The crew's on sale if you want a shit game.
Let's have an online-only, competitive, multiplayer racing game.
There isn't simulation, so it's going to be shit, in my opinion. It doesn't handle wheels well, either.
Which, for a racing game...
It's, like, the main fucking point.
I've seen a dude, like, play through, what was it he played through? Was it... Oh god, I can't even think now.
I've seen the Dark Souls with a Guitar Hero controller.
That's what I was going to, Dark Souls with a Guitar Hero controller. Man, that's amazing.
I've seen someone try it with the steering wheel.
I've seen somebody play something else with a graphics tablet, and that was quite interesting as well. But what's I mean, that? Like, a lot of games you can probably get away with a graphics tablet. Stuff like Civ or...
I will admit, I have actually played Counter-Strike with a graphics tablet. I actually got a couple of kills for some fucking reason.
Accidents.
I don't know how. Yeah, they were just pure accidents, but... Yeah.
Look, as we discussed before we went on, Firewatch is on sale. £1.50 off the RRP on launch day.
I like the look of that Firewatch, though.
I think it's supposed to be about 8 hours long from what I was reading online yesterday. I suppose it's maybe very story-driven, if it's the thing I was reading last night. I don't fucking know. It was late.
Speaking of story, which... the story-driven single-player games. Have either of you got around to playing The Park?
No.
Never even heard of it.
You have heard of it, because I told you multiple times that you needed to play it.
When have I ever listened to you?
Yeah.
Oh, damn it, I forgot about my grenades.
Fallout 4's on sale.
How much is off?
I already own it.
£26.79 it is now.
Man, that's dropped quick.
It's a Bethesda game.
Yeah, but still, that's dropped quite quick.
Speaking of which, The Witcher 3 is on sale.
It's still like £25 or something, isn't it?
Yeah.
I'm not going to buy that until I get the other two finished. And by that time, it'll be like a fiver anyway, so.
There'll be Witcher like 7 out by then.
Rust is on sale.
That's another one that's kind of interesting. I've seen lots of people
playing it. I've watched some
of
the videos,
I think we'd have a laugh playing something like Rust, but it'd have to be on a private server because there's no way we'd end up working together. And if we weren't working together, we'd just get owned by everybody who's already on the server.
Yeah.
So basically, if we all bought that, it's Fat Boy, do you want to set up a server?
No.
They'd never pay for it.
I gotta set up a server anyway. I keep meaning to get around to it. But...
I think Minecraft's still running.
It was last time you checked, yeah. H1Z1 is on sale, £11.24. Still £11 too expensive.
I wouldn't even pay for 24p, brutally fucking honest.
I'd pay 24p for a 4-pack.
I'd pay for 24p for a 4-pack of beer, yes. Not that game, no.
Armor Free's on sale, $17.99.
That's a good deal. Well, admit, I paid full price. Actually, no, I paid like £10 cheaper because I bought it in early access.
Life is Strange is on sale. That's only $1.99.
Not played it.
Yeah, it's one of these clicking point adventures.
Oh yeah, the old.
Wow, I call it a clicking point. It's not a clicking point. It's
basically the genre that Telltale Games made up.
Yeah.
Back in the day with the old ones. What? Max.
It's not a real game.
Telltale Games didn't make up a genre. They just picked up on the old adventure game style. Really.
Yeah, but to become basically the people for it, though.
Yeah, but,
which isn't a bad thing. I mean, that type of game has been very underrated.
Right,
I do like some of them, don't get me wrong.
In fairness, the moment somebody else releases a game that can rival Monkey Island, I'll buy it. Until that point, I'm going to carry on playing Monkey Island.
Yeah, that's fair.
Killing Floor 2's on sale? Yeah. I think I played it on the free weekend and I was bored.
Yeah, I didn't get into it. Dark Souls 2's on sale, and that's Scholar of the First Sin. The original XCOM Enemy Unknown's on sale, £3.74, so if you want to get into the new one but you don't quite want to drop 30, 40 quid on a game just now, then it's a good way to get into it. City Skylines, which is basically the Sim City that works.
A very, very, very competent Sim City, honestly.
Hello, Mad Darkness. Welcome to the chat.
it's actually a much deeper SimCity.
Yeah, there's a lot you can do with it. There's a lot of mods for it too.
This fucking game won't stay on the right bloody screen. Oh, it's done it again. Right, I'm going to stop playing that now because every time it's just... Oh.
Football Manager 2016 is on sale if anyone wants to, I don't know, kill themselves.
Did you guys notice we had someone watching?
No,
what?
No.
Just me.
Because yes.
No, it just says two here. Mad Darkness. Mad Darkness says, I beat that game. I don't know what game you're on about, mate. If you let us know. I feel like they made a subgenre. I don't know what game you're on about. That's not what game you're on about. I think it's Life is Strange, I think he's on about. But I don't know.
But that's the only time we've really mentioned genres so far.
Yeah, I'm going to say it's, on about Telltale Games.
He's obviously paying more attention to you than I have, so, you know.
Will we go over the Xbox sales? No, because I didn't know there was one on.
Wait, Xbox has sales?
Xbox has some pretty good sales, actually.
It did sales. I take it that's on the Xbox store, yeah.
Yeah, on the Xbox store. And with Xbox as well, when you're a gold member, I assume they do the same with PlayStation Plus or whatever they call it nowadays.
Oh, you get additional discounts, don't you?
Yeah, you get additional discounts on games and stuff. So brand new games, instead of being 40, 50 quid, they might be 35 quid or they might be 40 quid opposed to 50 quid.
Yeah, PSN Plus does it, yeah.
I haven't bought Xbox games. I actually haven't touched an Xbox in like 3 years or more, possibly.
The
only sales I ever noticed when it comes to Xboxes were like in game. So,
in game, why would you be in game if you play on PC? Because the fucking prices in there are atrocious on PC games. I
have a wander in just out of curiosity now and again. Sometimes they got cool fucking gadgets and toys.
I saw a boxed copy of Ark in there the other last weekend. They wanted 25 quid for it.
For Ark?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's $22.99 without a sale.
Well, I was going to look at something else, and I was going to say that was on sale as well. Where was I? Oh, Skyrim.
I think Ark is on sale.
Skyrim is on sale, £2.49. If you don't already own Skyrim, no.
Is that the Game of the Year edition, the bundle?
No, that's only the normal one.
I bet I'm getting later.
Yeah, I assume still the Game of the Year edition is probably going to be like a fiver.
It's usually like fiver on sale, yeah. I still haven't... I don't like them. I don't like the medieval style setting, you know what I mean?
It's not medieval.
But you know what I mean?
No. It's high fantasy.
Yeah, I just... Yeah, I don't get it. It's not for me. Yeah, I play D&D. Figure that out.
This makes no fucking sense.
Well, you play D&D when you turn up.
Hey! I turned up 2 weeks in a row. Piss off.
I know. Witcher 2 is also on sale.
All of them are on sale.
Oh yeah, the entire front. I've already covered that. Left 4 Dead 2, only $2.99. If you want to play some Teletubbies mods.
Oh god damn, the Teletubbies mod is the bomb.
What? Really?
Supposedly we'll get a bigger audience if we do all platforms. One main issue. I play PC. Pants plays PC. Talk owns an Xbox, that's it. Nobody owns a PS4 or a PlayStation 3 or whatever.
In fairness, since November, the only game that's been played on my Xbox has been Fallout 4.
Yeah. Exactly. That's all you bought it for, really.
In fact, I only took the game disc out the other day to play a DVD.
Wow, man. DVD. Feels a bit retro there.
Well, the only other game that's...
Another one that's on bloody sale. The Deadpool game's on sale again, which I have been... bursting to get a hold of that game, but I'm not paying 15 fucking quid for it.
No, when it's already been taken, it's got taken down, not price after release. Well.
30 quid still, and it's like old now. What is it?
It's not even a great game. I'll be brutally honest. It's funny, but it's not great.
It's the comedy. Yeah,
it's just a hack and slash adventure game. That's all it is. Exactly.
Yeah, I wouldn't say it's a bad game. It's just I wouldn't pay 15 quid for it. I would feel ripped off 15 quid.
Right. Okay. Let's get into some serious talk now, because there's a load of Star Wars games on sale.
Aren't they always on sale too?
Star Wars Jedi Academy is on sale. Star Wars Jedi Outcast is on sale. Star Wars Battlefront 2, which is the last decent Battlefront game, is also on sale.
I own that. It's a pain in the ass to get running on Windows 10.
It's a pain in the ass to get running on anything past Windows XP, I think. And
can we just put it like nice and simple that all the Star Wars games on Steam are on sale?
and they all seem to be £2.09.
Yeah.
I blame Disney. I don't know why.
Dark Forces, Knights of the Old Republic, Force Unleashed 2, Battlefront 2, Empire at War Gold, Jedi Knight Dark Forces, Jedi Knight Jedi Academy, Jedi Knight Mysteries of the Sith, which is one of the few I've not got, Jedi Knight 2 Outcasts, Jedi Outcast, Knights of the Old Republic, Republic Commando, Starfighter, and the Clone Wars. Whew, all on sale. And you can get them all in a package for £17. Well, £17.50.
You might need to like dust off your old computer to get most of them running now.
No, I can run Dark Forces and whatnot on mine just fine. Steam actually deals with all the DOSBox nonsense for you.
Oh yeah, yeah, like GOG did.
Mm-hmm. Which is actually pretty good.
Kerbal Space Program's on sale for $17.99. That's a good game. Fucking hard though. I've killed so many like Kerbal guys. It's unreal. It was pretty much genocide. It was genocide space program.
Yeah, I think most people play like that.
But I've seen some cool stuff of people what they're making, and it's like, yeah, that's cool. I can't do it, but that's cool. Dead Defeat Source is on sale for £1.74.
Mm-hmm. You know, I'm looking at Rust as you mentioned it earlier, and you know it. Thank you, Tat.
What's he just done? I missed that.
Found a Star Wars game he didn't have. It was 49p.
We just bought it for him. Well nice. Played.
Thank you. You didn't have to. Much appreciated.
It was 49p. I've just sold a load of cards on Steam. You're fine.
Just to buy him a game.
No, but I sell the cards anyway.
Yeah, I do.
Actually, that's a good point. We should be buying these games to get cards.
Looking at Rust. It looks like Daisy and Ark and so on and so forth.
They all kind of come out around the same time.
It's the same sort of general idea.
It's quite a big genre now.
It's getting kind of oversaturated though, do you not think?
Yeah, 6 months ago. It's oversaturated, really.
Well, this is the thing I was saying to Fatboy last year when I started playing... Stranded Deep.
Yeah.
Stranded Deep was nice because it was that sort of survival game.
It was completely different in everything.
But it was different and you didn't have zombies?
Yeah. Rush to remove their zombies though, didn't they? What I remember.
Yeah, because they couldn't get them to work properly.
Yeah, nobody's got zombies to work properly except for Valve with Left 4 Dead and that's it.
The forest isn't too bad for zombies.
Zombies though, were they? I thought they were cannibals or some shit.
The cannibal zombies.
Same kind of thing, really.
Yeah, I suppose.
Oh, mate, Bush Driver's on sale for £1.74.
God damn it, I've just spent 49p.
Worst thing, I already own it.
What's that?
Bush Driver.
Oh, another one.
Guess what you do?
It takes a huge amount of guesswork, that, doesn't it?
Payday 2's on sale again.
Oh!
Which means the DLC might be 2.
Ooh!
It's DLC simulated like gamers. And they just released a new one as well. I think it's a free one now.
No, the last one they released was Goat Simulator.
No, I'm sure they released a new one. I read it somewhere.
Yeah, the DLC's on sale too.
Couldn't get too far, Fox, I'll be brutally honest. You know my, you know.
Yeah, I know, but I only buy DLC when it's on sale. I don't buy it at full price.
You're the reason they keep releasing DLC.
They keep putting it on sale.
That's... give up. That's meant to be good. The Mountain Blade games. They're on sale. Mountain Blade with Fire and Sword is like £2.71. The full collection is £11.89. So they meant to be good. Never actually played them though.
Ooh. I could get a minigun.
Fuck my life.
How many doing it now to wind you up?
I know! You absolute prick.
I'm freaking lost now. Where am I?
I don't know. I'm lost too. Yeah, somebody else.
I'm wearing out my scroll wheel here.
Subnautica's on
Wolf
sale.
Here, De La Cruz. Hello. Other person in chat.
Hello, guy.
Hello.
Ovier De La Cruz.
Ovier De La Cruz, I'm going to know it. Yeah.
Yeah.
This is why Pants is a social media ambassador and I just do stuff.
Yeah. Get your last live Redux is on sale there. That's a good price.
Yeah, that's another couple of games I've kind of wanted. I've got Metro 2033, the original one. And kind of fancied picking up the Redux.
Yeah, I've played 2033. I've not played it yet.
Ooh. But again, I've got so much stuff to bloody play. I don't know if
I've got 273 games. I know the problem.
Yeah, good.
I don't even like half of them.
Ovier.
208. See? Ovier. I was close.
Sonic Hedgehog 4. Oh, wait, it's fucking episode fucking something. Why have you got episodes of Sonic names?
Oh, because somebody started selling games in episodes. Naming the names, but Telltale. And then everybody thought it'd be a really
No. Wrong. Valve started that one.
Yeah,
well.
But the Valve episodes were a bit longer than 25 fucking minutes, let's put it fair.
True.
No, Telltale games ones take more than 25 minutes.
No, it takes me about 25 minutes to get annoyed and throw the controller down.
Ah, okay, then.
Bioshock 2, the worst, second worst Bioshock game,
hell.
Is on sale.
What a terrible sequel that was.
Second worst? What, do you think Infinite's worse than that?
Yeah.
Really? I got Infinite for free and I wanted my money back. I did not enjoy it.
I paid for Infinite and then got it for free and I still want my fucking money back.
I quite liked Infinite.
It was an okay game, but it didn't feel like a Bioshock game. It was too bright.
There was a sky.
Yeah, there was sky. I didn't need that in my life. If I wanted to look at the sky, I'd leave the house, and I won't even do that.
Oh, The Long Dark's on sale.
Mm-hmm.
That's a good game if you don't own it. I'm thoroughly enjoying it. And they're not constant updates, but they are updating the game slowly, which I would rather them updated slowly and not break it than constant updates and keep breaking it.
Yeah. What do you mean?
Project Cars is on sale.
Fuck off. You're not going to be started about that heaping pile. Actually, no. I can play it now because I've got the right fucking brand of graphics card.
Now, but, you see...
Yeah, just don't get me started with that.
That's a sale. Grand Theft 3, Vice City, the best Grand Theft Auto there is, and San Andreas for £1.49.
San Andreas, yes.
No, Vice City was the best Grand Theft Auto. Always has been, always will be.
Stalker Call of Pripyat, $6.49. That's a good fucking deal. I might have to buy that. I think I actually own it on disc somewhere.
Oh, Euro Truck Simulator, the original, is £1.49.
It's so fucking bad. It's unreal.
I was going to say there's one called Bus Driver on there as well.
Elite Dangerous is on sale.
Mm-hmm.
But that's just the core... Elite Dangerous, that's not the
that's
new
the one I've got. Yeah. I still haven't actually started playing that. Now I've got a decent graphics card.
Horizons. The Horizons update isn't a necessity to play Elite. If you just want spaceflight and you're not too fussed about the planetary landing stuff for the moment, then you can buy it. It's a full-on game. You know, it's all there.
I've got it, and there is a lot to do. It's just bothered.
In all fairness, that's about the only bit about Elite that I am actually interested in. I don't like the landing on planets and going around doing shit. I just want to be able to fly around in space and blow shit up.
In all honesty, what's the best way of putting it? I would say there's not a huge amount of stuff to do in Horizons yet with the planetary landings, but it's not shit either, if you know what I mean.
They're slowly releasing stuff.
And you can see kind of where it's going, which is looking good, but at the same time, it's not really necessary at this point. You don't have to have it to still enjoy the game or do everything that everyone else can do.
Mm. Oh, I've just found a game for Fatboy. 4.
If it's bad rats, I will like come down to your house and beat you to death.
No, it's called Depth. It's on sale. It's 75% off. So it's only.
Is this the shark one?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the shark one.
How much is it?
£4.74.
Too rich for me.
Then there's Rebel Galaxy.
Don't know that one.
Psychonauts is 69p.
Wait, hang on.
Windward is on sale again. £5.49. Now that's really actually quite good. I have to do a stream about that at some point.
Oh, Banished is on sale. That's a decent game if you actually like the sort of sim games.
Oh, yeah, I remember that, yeah. Is it like God Sim, isn't it?
Yeah, like a God Sim. But it's actually really hard. From the get-go, it's really hard. There's not a lot easy about it. If you don't pay attention to the minute tutorial, you are fucked.
Yeah. Blood Bowl Chaos Edition to 5, that's not bad.
Oh, Game Dev Tycoon is £4.47. That's a decent game.
Just buy it for your phone, it's way cheaper.
I've got Game Dev Story.
Same game, pretty much.
Yeah, I know. I fucking love Game Dev Story, man.
Have you seen the pirated version? That?
When you get so
basically,
far
yeah,
in.
You can't sell games because people keep pirating them in the pirate version. Love it.
That's clever. Yeah.
It's like Armor 2. The way their copy protection worked, it worked perfectly fine for a couple of hours. Then after that, your bullets just started going everywhere. Once what happened to me, basically the bullet literally curved around and then killed me. In a pirate copy once, which is hilarious.
That's what you...
This was donkeys ago, though. You know, when Armor 2 was actually relevant.
Armor 2 still is relevant.
Only because of freaking DayZ, but that's it.
Yeah, the only DayZ... The only DayZ that actually works...
Is the mod version, yes.
Speaking of which, DayZ is also on sale. I think it's about 15 quid.
It's 20 quid too much.
Yeah, pretty much.
You should pay me to play that game.
Oh, Batman Arkham Asylum is on sale. £3.74. That's a really good game.
It actually works. I still not finished that as well.
Yeah, yeah. Because a different team handled the PC port.
Alan Wake. That's a good game.
I own them, actually.
Shut your filthy mouth.
I really liked Alan Wake.
I followed Alan Wake for about 10 fucking years, and then when they finally released it was crap.
It's nothing like what they claimed it would be, yes, but it was still a good game.
So they pulled a Spore, then?
No, they pulled a Duke Nukem.
Fucking hell.
Yeah, they had big, big, big plans, and
then it was
that they had advertised it, and
it was,
topped up.
The DLC will be coming by the end of the year.
Did it ever come out?
No, they released a prequel DLC.
Yeah, because I own both of them.
And the prequel DLC was actually a lot more like sort of a Dead Rising sort of game.
Was it a prequel, though?
What, American Nightmare?
American Nightmare, yeah.
A prequel dream sequence.
Yeah, it's odd. It's really hard to play. I've only played like the first level of it, but it's really hard to tell whether it's set before or after. So
there is a game here I am tempted with, though.
If it's Sleeping Dogs, don't bother.
No, I've just properly shite that game is. Convoy. It's basically FTL but Mad Max style.
I could get down with that. That'd be
cool. Yeah, it does look fun.
The Room is on sale. Not to be confused with Silent Hill, The Room.
Ooh, have you heard about the re-releasing The Ship as a remastered version?
Yes, I've known this. They've been doing this for 5 freaking years.
Yeah, I can't wait for that. It's going to be some fun.
I know, because now the only servers that still work for The Ship are private servers.
Yeah, because people are hosting them. I could host a server for that. Just getting the people to play, though.
Yeah, but it's also picking the game up when it's at the right price, because they still want stupid money for the game.
Yeah, and they can fuck that off.
For a dead
game... I might wait till the re-release and buy it then. Buy the re-release version.
Well, it depends whether the re-release actually picks up any attention. Because if anybody that was interested in a game like The Ship probably bought The Ship, and if they've all lost interest by this point, because there's I
think the people who played the original ship will be like, ah, we'll buy that and start playing.
Mate, the ship, the ship is just a cult classic, right? It's like Postal 2.
Yeah, right? I own that. Hilarious game.
They're not terribly great games. Yeah, I own Postal 2 as well, and the DLC, because I brought it in the sale last time. We were talking about it online, and I just went and brought it. But it's one of those things where there are going to be constantly people wanting to play it. It's a really good game. It's got a really nice way that it handles everything, and it's fun to play, and it's great to play in a team of people, especially if you're all on Skype and you're shit talking each other while you're playing.
Yeah, I think that when it comes out, I think we should all buy that. That'd be hilarious.
Remember we were talking about this last week. Fantasy Grounds is on sale.
It's too fucking expensive.
It's only 10% off. But well, it's like.
But the thing is, though,
it only released.
The best way to do
last year, is it?
Is have 4 players all chip in and buy a single copy. Is like the DM edition. And your DM has that, and then anyone can connect for free. Then, without everyone have to, every single person having to buy the game. But that's still like 150 fucking quid for the DM edition or something stupid.
To be honest, with the Fantasy Ground stuff, it's okay, but I would rather use Roll20 for that sort of thing.
I'd rather have the issues that we do have with Roll20 every now and again than paying how much they fucking want for basically the same kind of thing.
Yeah, that's
what I mean.
The thing is, with Roll20 as well, there's such a large user base that use it. If you've got an issue, you've only got
knows a trick like how to fix it.
Yeah, you've only got to Google it.
And then it's like, oh, you want to like play a game, and you know, your usual group isn't there. You can go and find a group quite easily.
Oh, it's brilliant. The whole thing is fantastic. Oh, XCOM UFO Defense is on sale, 74p.
Oh, that game finally released. Sorry, Automation, the car company tycoon game. It's basically you build cars. Oh, it's early access. Yeah. 20 fucking quid, though. Oof.
See, anything early access should be a tenner maximum. And then if they want to sell it for more afterwards, fine. But, because a lot of these early access games never really get finished. Not the way that they keep saying they're going to.
Well, I mean, that's one, again, if you look at, what was it? Was it Rust? I think it was Rust. It released into early access alpha copy in 2013. It's almost 3 fucking years, and it's not progressed effectively. It's still early access. That's
In that time, you've had Tabletop Simulator, Kerbal Space Program, what else is the other one? Space Engineers. Actually, no, that's still in early access, I think. But they've got like so much further, all these other games. Especially Space Engineers.
And DayZ's the same boat as well.
Yeah, it's in development hell.
Uh-huh.
DayZ is in development hell because they decided to make a mod into a fully fledged game.
Well, the mod got picked up by the owner of Armor, like Bohemia Interactive.
No, the guy that originally created DayZ as the Armor mod got hired by, I believe, and then decided he was picking it up to do a proper full-on game with.
Yeah.
If I remember,
and then he's already left the team as well. He left end of last year.
The simple fact of the matter is the DayZ mod for Arma 2 got took over by the community and various people.
The community devs have actually sorted it out,
and it works, and it works really well. And they fixed all the issues that it had, and so on and so forth. And the mod's fantastic, which. The standalone game has suffered from because it doesn't have that team of people.
Yeah, my main major issue with standalone is it's a modified version of the Take-On Helicopters engine.
Yeah.
Why they didn't use the Armor 3 version, I don't know. Because he had access to it before he did the standalone version.
Yeah, they would have done.
And the Armor 3 Armor 3 engine is so much superior compared to all the other ones.
Hmm.
The main thing, it actually works in multiplayer. It yeah, it is still kind of server restricted, but it's not as bad. Do you know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know why we've never done that way, especially when you've got like Breaking Point as a mod for Armor 3 that's a whole ton better than it.
Oh yeah. I think that's also part of the problem with DayZ as well, is the fact that they've got mods for Arma 3 that have come out that are better than the standalone DayZ.
And people would rather just play the mod, because they already own it in Arma 3. You know what I mean? The mod's free. There you go. Why spend 15, 20 quid, whatever, pay for a standalone game that doesn't work? They've made the money, don't get me wrong.
Mm-hmm.
They made a lot of money.
Oh, God, no. Please get me away from that.
Somebody buying Bad Rats.
No, Eve Game Time is on sale.
Oh shit. Stay away, Tom.
I'm fine, I've scrolled past it. I'm not doing that anymore. I didn't play that much of it anyway, I only played it for about 6 months.
Yeah, but it's like digital crack. It is, honestly. The amount of times I've lay in bed at night thinking, oh, I might start up Eve again tomorrow. Then I wake up the next day and go, nah.
What the hell was I thinking? Yeah,
why would I want to do this to myself?
Oh, Sir, You're Being Hunted is on sale.
Mm.
Which is brilliant. You just get sort of dropped into a world and you've got to collect these tablets and you've got to go up against these these robots that are basically aristocrats, and it's like all sort of like Victorian sort of England sort of way of doing things.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've seen that one.
That's a really bad way to explain it, but the game is awesome. Cut the Rope is on sale.
Good Android game, actually, that was.
Yeah.
Time waster.
So, where are we now?
I think we're all just scrolling and just finding, just laughing at all the stupid shit that they're trying to sell.
I'm now getting down to games that I have no idea what half of them actually are.
Mm.
Yeah, same. Like, please don't touch anything. I'm not going to click that then.
Bloody Trap Land.
Putt-Putt joins the parade. It's Putt-Putt's first adventure. Oh, it sounds fucking horrendously shit.
Maybe
I'm guessing it's some kind of kids game.
Maybe that's what we should be doing. We should just be playing horrendously shit games.
Have you seen the shit I already play?
Oh, System Shock's on sale.
Yeah, I saw that as I scrolled down. I do need to complete that game, I'll admit.
Moving away. That's the enhanced edition. I have the original one, so I don't want an enhanced edition. Construction Simulator Gold Edition.
It's crap.
Don't ruin it for me, man.
Just letting you know.
Deadlight is on sale.
Pajama Sam 2 and 3 are on sale. Oh, sweet. I found the game for you, Talk.
Go on.
Leisure Suit Larry Reloaded. It's
$5.99. Do I already own it?
I think it's a remaster.
If it's a remaster, I probably
don't. Leisure Suit Larry in the Land of the Lounge Lizards Reloaded, so yeah, I think it's a remaster.
I've got the original.
I just think it'd be hilarious to stream, to be honest. Oh shit, now I've got to scroll again.
That's why I'm not clicking on anything, man.
Yeah, but I can't see this fucking scroll bar because I've got a fucking Steam skin.
I saw a good video last night, actually. John Trump put up a video about Guns of Icarus Online.
Oh, the game that we all bought and we never played.
What, like Insurgency, you mean?
We
play Insurgency.
We played a lot more Insurgency, trust me.
Well, I've not bloody played it yet.
I've got it. I believe I've got it installed, actually.
I have, yes.
No, I haven't.
I have. I'll keep it installed, because I do play it every now and again. I've got it. I need to change mine, actually, because I'm into Peter Branch for the World War II mod.
What did I install, then? Because I installed something. I remember installing something. Oh, I installed Long Dark. Okay.
Yeah.
Bully Scholarship Editions to $2.49.
I love Bully.
Meant to be good.
I really want them to make a second one.
They're never going to do it. Rockstar are making way too much money from fucking shark cards for GTA Online.
This is the thing. Rockstar have gotten themselves all mainstream and interesting. They're not going to do anything controversial anymore. No. The Grand Theft Auto is about as far as they're going to push it.
And even that's watered down.
Yeah. And that's, yeah, significantly so. So, yeah, Grand Theft Auto Rockstar Games are past their prime, if you like.
They're making way too much money via shark cards. Simple as that. Why would they bother making games if they can keep milking that? When that dries up, they might make a new game. It'll be GTA 6, but yeah.
You're an ass, fat boy.
Why? What have you bought?
Bully.
Don't you already own it on, like, how many consoles?
I own it on PS2, Xbox 360, and now PC.
Man, you are, like, the only person I know who, like, triple, quadruple dips on games. You're, like, the perfect consumer for games, honestly.
Generally, if it's made... Only usually if it's made by Bethesda, which is strange, but... Well, I like the console versions, especially the Xbox version, because it tends to be the least buggy out of all the versions.
Until PC version gets mods, and then different story.
Yeah, but the mods can also be the most...
Just as buggy, yeah.
The mods can actually be the most dangerous part about it.
Yeah, you end up going down the rabbit hole of mods, and then you don't know... It's a completely different game when you're finished.
It is. Well, I mean, you saw the last time I was playing New Vegas. That was,
wow, that was hilarious.
A completely different game.
It's fucking hilarious. 10 deaths in, like, God, it's the smallest amount of time. Here you go. I've got a game. If I had the money, I'd buy it for you. But PewDiePie, Legend of the Brofist. It's £4.19.
Do you want?
Why is that even a game?
I don't fucking know. The man's a millionaire. He gets paid multiple millions a year to play games.
I just find him really annoying.
Don't get me wrong, he's got his demographic down.
Yeah.
He is a smart man about that. I'll give him credit for that. God damn, is he fucking annoying.
I don't like him. I've only ever watched one video of his.
I can respect the shit he does. I mean, he
plays
his games well. He entertains his core audience, and he does a lot of charity shit, which is.
I've got no issue with that. I've just got the issue with.
But I still find
his demographic. It's pretty much that's it. His demographic and what he has to do to keep that demographic.
Well, like I said before, I've only ever watched one video of his, and that's because my artwork was in it.
Space Farmers, was it? No.
Yeah, Space Farmers. Yeah.
Knights and Pen and Paper plus one editions, $1.99.
Oh, you bastard.
It's really good. I own it on
Android. You should really stop talking to us. We're costing you a fortune.
Why have you got money in your bank account? That's what I'm worried about. Well, why did you have money in your bank account?
This
is the right question, I suppose.
Because I've needed to buy stuff online the last couple of weeks or so, but when I do, it's like £5 here, £6 there, and
yeah.
I just put however much in.
Yeah, no. Yeah, Knights of Pen and Paper is actually a surprisingly good game.
No, I'm not going to buy Knights of Pen and Paper, because I've bought and downloaded fucking Bully. Probably shouldn't be downloading that now, actually.
No, because you're never going to go to sleep.
Oh, no, it'll be downloaded before I go to sleep. It's an old game, man. It's only like...
No, what about the fact you'll end up playing it?
Yeah.
Airport Madness World Edition. I don't even want to click on it, because I'm not scrolling this far down again.
But in fairness, I've only brought two things tonight, and one of them wasn't for me.
Camera's off a minute.
I noticed.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I like Steam sales, but they cost me a fucking fortune.
I haven't bought anything in Steam sale in a good while thinking about it. I own that many games. I just stop buying them now, really. Unless it's something really good and I do want to play it.
Let's go check out Early Access. That'll stop us buying shit.
Yeah, because I've been a small one. Oh, wait. Yep. Oh, they got Knights of Pen and Paper 2 for £2.79.
I know, I saw that.
It's actually meant to be a shitter version. Supposedly some in-app purchases. I know on Android they got the fucking in-app purchases. Shit out of it. What's the difference between the normal edition and deluxe edition?
You probably get extra shit in deluxe edition. £30.98 for a fucking early access game.
Fucking hell, yeah. 15... Top sellers of early access. Ooh. That's a shocker. DayZ isn't at the top for once.
No, Ark's at the top because it's been in every single fucking sale so far.
Mm-hmm. It has, actually. Yeah.
That scrap mechanic looks fun.
Squad, I've heard interesting things about.
Yes, I want to play that, but I'm not paying 30 fucking quid for an early access game. Because I do like that kind of game.
I don't know. It.
I kind of like the name, Naval Action. I'm not sure if I'd like the game. Then again, Detailed Naval Combat Sandbox. But then again, 30 quid for an early access game. The Fall.
Exactly. I'm sorry. If Squad was 20 quid, it would have been a day one buy.
I don't...
That 10 quid makes a lot of difference for me. I don't know why, it just does. The thing is, it's online only as well. So that's why I'm kind of worried about it.
I don't like online only stuff. Because it just... Sometimes I don't want to play with people.
Mm. It stagnates very quickly.
It'd be alright if... Well, the thing is, it's with Squad, it's 50 versus 50. So you do have to wait properly.
Mm. Well, that's me.
It does look quite pretty in the screenshots.
Yeah.
Oh, that'll cripple even my new graphics card, I think.
Hello, Wall Hunter. Names.
Oh, Wall Hunter?
I am needed. I will be back shortly.
You needed here for the social media crap.
That's why I made him the social media ambassador. God damn it.
We tried.
Lego Worlds. Now, see, Lego Worlds, I'm quite...
Interests me.
Yeah. But I don't know. It's just...
I have played a bit.
But if it's just building, it's basically Minecraft with Legos. But then it's not, because there's stuff to explore and do. And But then I'm just like... It still seems very Minecraft-y, but in third person.
You know, we were talking about the ship, the remastered version.
Mm-hmm.
It gets released on the 15th into early access.
Where, what page are you on?
I went on to the coming soon bit.
Okay, coming soon.
Oh, I don't know how much it's going to be, but.
Add to wish list.
Yeah, I think it's
going to follow.
The specs, they're not asking stupid specs, thankfully, because obviously it isn't the prettiest game.
No, it's just a remaster of the old one.
Don't get me wrong, it looks okay. You know what I mean? The lighting looks good. Is it like in motion? It looks alright.
Oh, I could buy Counter-Strike Global Offensive.
Why would you want to do that?
Because you know me and my FPS games, man, we get on so well.
Do you want to get insulted by Russians? Because that's how you get insulted by Russians.
You don't know. I might end up being very good at it.
Oh, no, you're going to dignify that. Let me see how long Mitch has been playing now.
How many thousand hours?
Mate, you should have seen when he used to play Dota 2. Jesus, titty Christ.
That's the thing with those games. If you don't play countless hours,
you lose your the meta game and you're fucked.
Like with Dota, it's all about when they change stuff.
Yeah, the meta game.
You've got to be there straight away when they change stuff to get on top of it.
Well, his Global Offensive hours on record is a lot higher than his Dota 2. Dota 2, I think he did it in about six, maybe 12 months. 332 hours on Dota 2. Which is respectable for a newbie, basically. Mitch's global offensive hours on record.
Mm-hmm.
Last played today. 834 hours.
He's as bad with that as I am Fallout.
Jeez.
Although, to be honest, he'll never beat me with Fallout.
Yeah, nobody's going to beat you with Fallout, mate.
Nah, I spoke to somebody who's got nearly twice as many hours in Fallout 4 as me.
Do they have a life?
Not really, no.
There you go.
But when you consider I've also played, like, about 100 hours of Payday 2 and...
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? I've played a lot of games the last, sort of, 6 months.
PC for you?
I've played a lot more since this has been in, man. A lot more. I can just do a lot more. I can play different types of games.
Yeah, you're not restricted, are you? Really? Well, yeah, I think that's pretty much all the decent sales. Well, like I said, there's nothing that's jumped out at me and made me want to buy it.
Well, like I said, I mean, there was one game that I'm actually... Oh, Dollhouse. That's what I'm looking forward to.
Never heard of it.
It's... I don't know how to explain it. You'll just have to find it. It's a horror adventure, survival sort of game. But it's very Art Deco-y. It's very... It's just a little bit different to everything else that you've...
Yeah.
And by the look of it, the entire game is in black and white. With little hints of colour and...
Yeah, I know what you mean.
Something just a little bit different.
Yeah, like a very artistic style as well.
Yeah.
It's a bold choice to do these days.
Well, I'm hoping it's going to work out for them. Because if games like that...
can do well, yeah, we can see something new... You know what I mean? This is one of the main issues with the big developers, isn't it? It's, we can make money doing this style of game, so we'll keep making the style of game.
Yeah, and then the consumer base don't get anything new, and when something new does come along, the consumer base is so used to what we've already been given that we just automatically write games off.
Or not even that, they all switch to that new style, and then everyone starts making that new style of game. See the whole zombie thing.
Voila, GP as
yes, I've just seen.
Ever walk on the sun.
Seeing as the sun is not actually got any
physical mass.
Physical, well,
it's got mass.
But there is no like solid to stand on, as it were.
Well, you don't know that necessarily.
It's plasma.
The center of it could be.
The center could be theoretically, but yeah, have fun with that. You know what, mate? You try first and let us know how it goes.
Yeah, I'm going to say, if you want to be the first person to attempt to walk on the sun, I am more than happy to fund you.
I will fund you a dollar.
A Canadian dollar. They're worth less than American dollars.
I was thinking...
Vietnamese was dollar.
Zimbabwean
dollar?
Yeah. It's like 0.00. Actually, no, they're not even in circulation anymore because they're that useless.
I was going
to
say.
We switched to the American dollar.
Yeah, and if you do get Zimbabwean money, that like smallest. Isn't that where the smallest, like.
It's like a million.
Yeah.
It's stupid.
Like $1 million. We should go there and just tweet a picture. Congratulations, Oxymoron just became millionaires.
Let's go all the way to Zimbabwe just for a giggle. My mum wanted me to walk on the sun, but she died when she tried flying up on her own homemade rocket ship. All right, mate. Take the meds.
Keep taking the meds.
Please take your meds. We finally get someone in chat, and this is what we get.
Yeah.
You know what? I'm happy about that. I'm happy about that, actually.
If we didn't have people trying to troll in the chat.
Oh, there'd be no one there.
The Stanley Parable's only $2.99.
It doesn't interest me. I understand the point of it. It's a narrative-driven game, isn't it?
Yeah.
What's it? Fuck, battery on the floor.
Oh, Monkey Island 2 is only £1.74.
You just bought it, haven't you?
No, I haven't, because I already own it. I don't think I own it on Steam, though. I think I...
Saw that. Come on.
No.
You were going, why am I so bored? Oh, yeah. Steam sale. Well, so I used to be the first couple of years when Steam was quite big. Well, this is it. After all, people like me are here to be expected. Yes, we're fine with that. It's good fun, actually.
In fairness, it's usually us.
Yeah, it's usually us giving each other shit like that. Well, true.
Oh, dude, Legacy of Kain Soul Reaver's on sale.
I think it might be in the PS2 collection on the side. Mate, I nearly bought a bunch more.
Well, that came out on the original PS PlayStation.
Here we go.
Yeah, I think it's in the collection, though.
Fucking did I miss anything?
Awesome game. We've just got our first troll of the evening.
Okay. I think it's our first proper one, actually.
No, we had that once, and we just
Viola,
sat
GP.
Here,
yes.
Ripping the piss out of him, and then he left.
Oh, aww. Yes, I remember that one. That was a while back.
But it's fine, Vola, you can carry on, because we don't block people on here unless they're soliciting other stuff, in which case they get blocked.
Yes.
That wasn't really trolling, that's just being a bit odd.
Like we said, we told him he needs to take his meds.
In fact, we insisted he take his meds.
Hell.
We also did fund him $1,000,000 for his trip to the sun.
So, as a social media ambassador, I'd like you to do the social media for that.
It'd be a really big check. Have fun mailing that.
Have fun cashing it.
It's $1,000,000. They don't even use them anymore.
The check will be worth more than the amount written on it.
Well, yeah, the paper is actually worth more than the actual what it means. Which is hilarious with that money. But yes. See, there's a game on Early Access called Void Destroyer 2, and I didn't click on it.
Why?
I've been on the internet too long. Just go with that. I'm going to click on it. Please be as bad as I think it's going to be. Alright. It's not as bad as I thought it's going to be.
Oh, that's quite a nice art style.
Yeah, actually. That's quite cool, actually. It reminds me of, you know, the cell shading from PS2 game called Auto Modelista.
No, but I know the sort of style you're talking about. It's that.
See, people say Borderlands and Borderlands 2 and all the Borderlands games are cel shaded. They're not.
No, it's not. It's just a general artistic choice in design.
It's because they I remember reading about it. Basically, when they were making the first one, to make it look somewhat realistic, it basically caned the computers they had.
Yeah, so they just...
So they switched out the art style just to make it work.
That doesn't look too bad. There is a Void Destroyer 1.
It's just... It's a risky name, you know?
Only if you've got the sort of... Oh, yeah, because the Void Destroyer 1, the art style's that same sort of art style, but it's a little bit dirtier, a bit more grimy. It's very Borderlands 2, sort of.
Yeah.
That sort of Borderlands feel and look.
Push this, follow, I want this.
So I think what they've done is they've gone a bit cleaner with it for the sequel to sort of get away from that Borderlands thing.
I just found an early access game. Air Missions Hind. It's an arcade combat... Wait, how is that possible? An arcade combat flight simulator. Explain that one to me, because I don't understand that. Based on the Russian Mi-24 Hind assault helicopter, to tear up the sky in a variety of single and multiplayer modes. Sounds cool.
I'm in.
Yeah. I do like me a good helicopter game.
The only time I'll go up in a helicopter is in a video game.
Oh,
no,
dude.
No way I'm going up in one in real life.
This looks awesome. Wish list. Kartcraft.
Dude.
It's a go-kart, simulator. I am so game for that. Like, unbelievably game for that.
What's it called?
Wait, where the fuck did it go? Cartcraft. It's craft with a K or one word.
I got it.
That looks so good.
Oh, well, we're talking about this sort of thing. I was at my mother's earlier, and we were flicking through the channels, trying to find the Liverpool
game. Right, dude, I'm going to have to go phone call. Sorry.
That's fine.
I'll just try and turn on my camera. I'll be back in a bit.
It's just a kart racing game. Whoa, that's epic.
That's right up his street, though.
Yeah, pretty much.
He plays trucks and I don't get it. It's probably along the same lines.
Dude, American Truck Simulator is awesome.
Oh, don't you start now.
Euro Truck Simulator was good.
2 seconds.
Okay, so I'll just sit here on my own and talk about video games.
Totally. I'll be a minute. God, settle.
Oh, actually, this will give me a chance to try something out. Pretty cool, right? You get the whole day off because of some ratchet weather. Being in Japan is kind of like that.
There. See, told you it wouldn't be long. Ah, I need brew. Did I miss anything then?
No, I'm just playing around now with the stream.
What are you doing to it?
Nothing.
Oh, right, okay. Hey! Put your overlay on.
No, the overlay was already on. I just put the thingy in.
Aye, the... what's it be called? Hey, so where did you get to? With the stuff.
We actually ended up going into the early access.
Ah.
So we were just randomly chatting about early access games.
Why? Or just cause?
Just cause?
Is there any way to find upcoming releases? Not that I'm actually going to buy any, but you know.
Yes. You want the coming soon tab.
That's the one. Upcoming, yes. Cat Simulator.
No.
Really? I don't know. Goat Simulator looked fun.
It's not as fun as you'd imagine.
Is it not? Alright, okay. Yeah, I'm not seeing anything in upcoming releases that's all that interesting.
There's not really much coming out, mate. That's the thing. It's going to be a really weird year.
Mm.
There's a couple of big games that'll drop. But other than that, it's just waiting till E3 to see what's going to come out at the end of the year.
When's E3? Is that...
what, April, May, is it?
I think so, isn't it? Yeah. There's so much just... I don't want to say rubbish. But so much stuff that doesn't, you know, back, if you go back 20 years, everything that came out was shiny and new and, ooh, what's this sort of thing. You know, you wanted to have at least a shot at the demo of every single game.
Yeah, and that's how you'd make up your mind.
Yeah, but now, it's just piles and piles and piles and piles and piles of stuff. Just getting dumped into the Steam store. And most of it is blatantly uninteresting.
Yes. And the reason for this is there are too many indie developers.
Yeah. I hate to say it, but yeah.
But there are. There are just too many indie developers. And people...
I mean, we wouldn't have Doom without indie, obviously. But... how do you find the next Doom amongst all of this crap.
Well, you don't, do you? I mean, you're not going to find the next Doom. It's just not going to happen.
You know what I mean, though.
Yeah, I know what you mean. But, I mean, really, what the problem is, the games industry used to work, like, I'm sorry to keep going back to them, but like Bethesda, they started making games on contract, basically.
Yeah.
One of their first games was a Madden game.
Ah, yeah.
Right?
That's right, yeah.
One of the most prolific PC developers now of all time, for good or bad. And the reason they managed to get to where they were is they managed to develop a pretty solid IP in-house. But they wouldn't have had the chance to develop that in-house
without the licensing thing first.
Yeah. So they were just approached to make games. They made the games. They did the work. Now, because developing games is seen as quite an easy route in, you just develop a couple of indie games and then you go and work for whoever.
Yeah.
People make indie games. And because of the likes of Steam, as much as we say we love it, the worst part about Steam is it's opened up the floodgates for anybody who is semi-competent at making games to come and drop games in.
Mm.
But the problem is the majority of games that are getting dropped on Steam are completing it a pish.
Yeah.
There's nothing really on Steam on a daily basis that's any better than what you would get from a AAA developer. And now these indie games are starting to climb up in price as well. So to keep up with the indie game scene, which is where, you know, proper gamers should be these days, instead of spending £5 on a game, you're spending £10 on a game. Then six months later, you're spending £15 on a game.
Yeah.
This time next year, the games, indie games, are going to be 30, 40 quid.
I honestly wouldn't piss on half of these games, to be honest.
But people do.
Mm. Well, obviously, yeah.
They find it one when it's cheap and they use it.
Mm.
And then the people will come along later and think, oh, my favourite YouTuber played that game. I've got to play that game.
Yeah, that could well be it, yeah.
So,
well, the first one I've seen of any interest, Doom, in May. Out of 9 pages.
Do you know who's publishing that?
No, oh, Bethesda, yes, indeed. What is, have they got ID Software under their thing now, is that what it is? Yeah.
They're part of ZeniMax Media.
Ah.
But the way ZeniMax work is, basically, they go in, they buy someone, and then they turn around to the company that they've brought and go,
hey, just do what you were doing.
Carry on what you were doing. We'll be over here when you need some cash.
See, that doesn't sound too bad, to be honest.
Because, like, you know Elder Scrolls Online?
Mm.
I can't remember the name of the company who was developing that, but ZeniMax brought them partway into development of the game.
Ah, okay.
Which was one of the reasons they made the choice to go free-to-play.
Uh-huh.
Is because once they had so much money coming from the first 12 months of people actually subscribing to the game, and then they saw the numbers dwindling, they just thought, right, we'll go free-to-play, we'll add in the Crown Store, whatever it is, and that will hopefully feed enough to keep the servers running.
Yeah.
And continue a little bit of development on the game. Obviously, development on the game was still going on.
Mm-hmm.
And it's worked out okay. It's not a terrible game. It's a lot more playable on Xbox, I feel, than on PC, but that's just because the PC control scheme is a little bit backwards.
Right.
It's basically essentially like me giving you Skyrim to play for a year and then going, here you go, here's Morrowind.
Right.
And you know yourself how finicky Morrowind could have been.
Yeah, indeed.
For the first 6 weeks of playing that game, you died.
Constantly.
That was it. You walked out of the first town. You walked down the road. You get approached by a robber. You think, I'm going to take you. You've only got a dagger. I've got this big ass sword. You die.
No, you don't. You die.
You try and avoid the robber. You end up walking into a swarm of mud crabs or something. You die.
Yep.
But yeah, Doom looks amazing. Something we are definitely going to cover on the channel because I think all of us want to play it. The multiplayer looks absolutely fantastic.
So I actually... Oh, you got into the beta alpha thing for... the alpha for Doom as well, didn't you?
Yes.
Did you ever get the chance to play it?
I played it for about 20-some hours.
Nice.
So not really.
Unfortunately, it's under NDA, but I will say, I quite enjoyed it. It was good.
I loved it. I thought it was really good.
And I'm old and have shit reflexes. And for an FPS, yeah, I liked.
I thought it was really good. It looks good.
Mm-hmm.
It didn't look like superbly great on my system, but that's my system, not the game.
Mm-hmm.
But yes, we will be covering that with Oxymoron at some point.
As soon as they let up on that NDA thing, that will be getting streamed to the fucking hilt.
The NDA will disappear a couple of days before release.
Nah, it'll probably disappear before beta.
I'm waiting for the beta, actually. I think the beta is when we'll really see, because the beta will be an open beta, I would assume.
Mm.
As is the way nowadays.
Mm-hmm.
I do get annoyed with a lot of companies when they do these open betas and stuff.
Yeah.
Because I've done alpha and beta on the new Fable game.
Mm-hmm.
All I'm going to say is, if they don't give me a copy, I'm not buying it. But yeah, because I just gave in with that because it's just not my cup of tea.
Yeah.
Squad-based games are not...
not your thing.
No.
See, I don't mind co-op squad-based stuff, like Payday. I'd say that's squad-based. But it works.
I'd really like to do more Payday, but like I said, I mean, we really do need a team of people.
Yeah, at least three.
Kind of want to play Payday now.
Oh dear.
What time is it anyway?
11:25.
We haven't got time to play Payday.
No, we could maybe do one and that would be it. But if we do one, then you'll just want to, we'll just do one that one more. And then it's 2 a.m. and we go and shit and you go to sleep. Because I'm up in an hour. Sort of thing.
Right, well, I think we can knock this on the head here.
I think so, yeah.
So, thank you.
Are we all game talked out, yeah?
Yeah, because we did like half an hour, 40 minutes worth of material before we came on air, as per usual.
Yeah, and then oh fuck, we should probably do this.
Yeah. But yes, thank you for watching. I've been Tok. He's been Fat Boy, although...
he's not here right now.
He's on the phone, which means we're going to have to hang around on Skype until he comes back, otherwise he's going to think we deserted him.
Well...
so we'll be hanging up Skype in about 2 seconds. he's been Pants. Pants, say goodbye.
Bye.
And together we have been Oxymoron Gaming. Available live on the Twitch. Available on the YouTubes. Available on the Twitters. Available on the Facebooks. Is there anywhere we're not available?
I don't know.
We haven't got an Instagram account.
No. Or Google Plus. No, we probably do have a Google Plus.
Yeah, we have a Google Plus, yeah.
I mean, YouTube. Yeah, that'll
Yeah, because I set up the YouTube at a time when you had to do Google.
Yeah, that's all right. We don't use it though, so don't bother looking.
That's fine, because nobody else uses Google Plus anyway.
Anyway, true. What else?
We'll have a MySpace page by the end of the week.
That would be impressive. I'll get the DeLorean.
We'll have a MySpace page, we just won't have any friends on it. So, tatty bye.
18-8.
Oh, also, all the links are actually below this video.
Ah, if you're watching on Twitch.
Yeah, and if you're watching on YouTube, they'll be below the video as well, because I've added them all into the box.
Ah, and you clever bugger.
Yeah. Done all this fucking work.
No fucker watches.
No.
The fuck?
Tatty bye.